Welcome back to Dr. Chow's YouTube channel. This is Dr. Chow from Howard County Board of Education. In this channel, I'm going to interview our high school graduates from Howard County Public School System. I want them to share their experience, their challenge, their achievement, and their advice for our incoming high school students. This YouTube channel will focus on our students' voice and our student experience. I hope this interview will help you, both the parent and the student, to navigate through your high school life. Today, we're going to interview Ms. Lorelei Loraine, who graduated from Mount Hebron High School in 2020. She will join Columbia University, majoring in economics and mathematics. Hi, welcome, Lorelei. Thanks for joining the program.
Thank you so much for having me.
Sure. Can you have a short introduction?
Yeah. So I recently graduated from Mount Hebron High School, where I participated in a lot of activities. I was on a competitive economics team, and we won the National Economics Challenge 2 years in a row. I was also captain of my school's dance team, and I focused a lot on social studies and public speaking activities, as well as really getting involved with my school. And outside of school, I've had a couple of part-time jobs, and I really like to volunteer, when things are open, I like to volunteer at my local nursing home.
Okay, thank you very much. I remember I keep receiving emails from your teacher, Mr. Van, right, about your competition achievement from Mount Hebron. Congratulations on the team. And it's so wonderful to see our students make great achievements, not just in the United States, but across the world. And this kind of world stage competition really help our students, I think, in broaden their learning experience, really see the whole world. Thanks for taking time speaking with me. My first question for you is, what was your most challenging experience in your senior year? How do you overcome that?
Senior year was, I think, mostly difficult because you have the dual challenges of a really hard class schedule while also trying to plan your entire future. So for a lot of people, time management was the biggest issue. And you know, I've always been a busy person, so time management is a muscle that I have strengthened a lot. And for me, the real challenge was sort of the anxiety and the psychological fear that comes with putting yourself out there for colleges to accept or reject. And for a lot of my peers and I, we had never really been flat out rejected before. And so, you know, that first letter was really hard. What really helped me was to just focus on the parts of my application that I felt really showed off who I was. And, you know, beyond the application, building confidence in myself to know that, you know, I know that I'm smart and I know that I'm doing great things, even if this college isn't necessarily for me.
I see. Thanks for sharing that. What was your feeling when you received your first rejection letter?
So my first rejection was actually, I got deferred from Harvard and then I was eventually rejected in the regular decision round. And that was really hard because I had visited the campus and really saw myself there. And so I think what was most difficult was, you know, closing that door and realizing that's not a future that I'm going to live. So that was really disappointing, but it was also motivating. You know, I learned a lot of lessons from my early decision round of applications, and I ended up, the school that I'm going to now, I applied to regular decision. And so I think as much as it was disheartening, it also showed me, you know, the gaps in my application and what I needed to focus on in the next round to be more successful.
I see. Thanks for sharing that. I believe it definitely is kind of heartbroken the first moment. Then you realize that life probably needs to move on. And there's so many great universities available, right?
And yeah.
Okay. Thanks for sharing that. So what was your biggest challenge in your whole high school year? And how do you overcome that?
I think that one of the things that was really hard for me was juggling all the responsibilities I had. You know, by the time I got to senior year, I'd been participating in a lot of clubs for 3 or 4 years. And so was kind of inevitable that I would take on responsibilities and take on leadership roles and things like that. And finding ways to spread myself between all of those and then also, you know, focus on enjoying my high school experience, focus on enjoying my time with my family and getting work experience and things outside of school was difficult. And I think it's something that I still haven't really mastered, but I'm still working on, you know, realizing what I value and assigning priorities to different activities.
Thanks for sharing that. So it's always not easy to balance everything out, right? Because you want to explore new stuff, you want to do well on what you are doing now, and then just try to balance that. It's probably something we need to learn or in our own life,
yeah.
I would say that. And so can you share one unique experience, academic experience, and maybe one class, one seminar, or maybe just one project?
Yeah, I took my junior year, a comparative politics class, and it was a class that hadn't really run before at Mount Everett. We were sort of the guinea pig class, but I took it with a great teacher, Mr. Eric Duke, and there were only 13 of us in the class. So he taught it basically like a college class, and that was my first introduction to, you know, what higher education might look like. It was really discussion-based. We did a lot of reading outside of class to prepare for our discussions. And so it didn't feel like a whole lot of homework, but I was always thinking about, you know, how to prepare, things I wanted to bring to the conversation the next class. And I think the most unique thing about it was that, you know, when I sit down to read the newspaper in the morning, I suddenly had this new understanding of international politics and also the critical thinking skills to make conclusions about those headlines that weren't in the articles.
Interesting. So because this is kind of, you really need to take your own initiative, right? Try to present what you learn and then present to others. It's not just you consume. You consume and then you need to present, right? So it's probably a little different.
Exactly.
I see. Interesting. Do you have any experience with bullying or cyberbullying in high school? How do you overcome that, or whether your friend experienced that as well?
So I've been at high school in HCPSS schools since kindergarten, and in that whole time, I've never experienced any bullying or cyberbullying, and I really haven't witnessed any either. In fact, my friends and I were talking the other day, you know, as much as the media and the movies make high school seem really scary, we really didn't witness anything, anyone ever being mean or, you know, discriminating against anyone. I think that we have really nice kids in our schools, and our, you know, the staff and the teachers do a really good job of mediating any conflict. So no, I haven't experienced any bullying at all.
Thanks for sharing that. Because we hear bullying and cyberbullying a lot. I'm really glad to hear that. Like, not, there are very few students experience that. At the same time, if you or your friends experience that, I just want to make sure, try to seek help from the school system. HCPSS has a robust and solid framework to handle the bullying or cyberbullying. We really want to help every student make sure they feel safe at school. Do you want to share some extra curriculum activities?
Yes, I think that my extracurricular activities were really what made high school so great. So like I said in the beginning, my main extracurricular activity is that I competed for 3 years on Mount Hebron's National Economics Challenge team, first in the high school division and then for 2 years in the university level division. And all 3 years we went to the national competition, and the lead up to that was very intense. We did a lot of studying outside of school. My first year, I actually had never taken an econ class. And so through that process, I really fell in love with economics, and that's what motivated me to keep coming back. And then, as I said before, I think the last 2 years, my team has won the national championship.
Congratulations.
Thank you. And that was a great experience because you really get exposure to people who are really admirable in your field, and you sort of get to take your education out of the school and, you know, show the world what you have and let the world teach you about economics and about, you know, international relations and things like that. And beyond Econ Challenge, I was really committed to two other speech and debate activities, those being mock trial and Model United Nations. And both of those, I think, really helped bring me out of my shell and really make some great friendships and get to travel and meet people who go to other high schools or even go to school in other states or countries. And finally, one of my very favorite extracurricular activities was being captain of the Lancers drill team. So we danced on the field with the marching band at football games, and we also competed in the wintertime. And getting to choreograph and teach and dance with so many girls and really build a family around something that we all loved was just so fun and really helped me get involved in my high school and made coming to school every day really fun.
Thanks for sharing that. Seems a lot of fun. So when you enter high school, maybe your parents give you some advice or your friends give you some advice. And based on your experience in the whole high school, do you have any advice for incoming high school students?
Yeah, I started high school with a very strict plan for what I was going to do in high school, what I was going to do after high school. That totally changed. That is not the plan that I followed, and it's not the plan I'm going to be following, and that's okay. I really encourage you to be curious about the opportunities that high school presents you, and not to be afraid to divert from what you think you like. You know, I was always an English person. You know, I never thought that I'd be pursuing STEM, and here I am doing a math degree. And I really didn't find the things that I loved until, you know, sophomore year, junior year, and even in senior year, I was finding new things that became really important to me. So I would say be open, and every time an opportunity comes to you, take it.
I see. Thanks for sharing that. So just try to open to new ideas and new possibilities and take the initiative, right? And you never know what you will end up, because you even have a great plan when you enter high school, but life is changing. Everything is changing, right? Just adapt to that change. Take advantage of the opportunities. So why choose Columbia University? And why choose economics and then mathematics as your major?
So like I said earlier, I'm a really big reader. I always loved English class and history class and things like that. And one thing that I loved about Columbia is they really focus on a liberal arts education and being a well-rounded student through their core curriculum. So, for example, every freshman takes a year-long course called Literature Humanities, where you read a book every week, which is daunting. But I really loved the idea that I'll come out of Columbia being with experience studying every field, and not just my major. Even though I love it so much, I really love that breadth that Columbia will give me. And as to why econ and math, my passion really lies in economics. That came from studying it so much to prepare for my National Economics Challenge competitions. I think that everyone has a little bit of you know, hero in them. Everyone wants to save the world. And to me, economics is a way to use data and information to materially change the world in a way that no other field can do. And I think that in order to maximize my potential to improve my surroundings, I want to get a PhD in economics. And a lot of graduate degree programs encourage a really strong degree or strong background in math. And, you know, I loved my calculus classes in high school, so I'm happy to study more math to support my passion for economics.
Great. Good luck in your college life and good luck in your pursuit of, I think it's kind of, if you want a PhD, it's kind of research area, right? So in your possible research in the future, I agree with you. economics and combined with mathematics and statistics really can change people's life and the country's life as well. They help make the sound decision, not just the decision come out from mind, right? Without any consideration, without any data backup. Do you have any advice for HCPSS where it can change, where it can improve?
Yeah. One thing that I really loved about growing up in HCPSS schools is I always felt like there was an exciting experience to be had around the corner. You know, in elementary school, we went on a lot of field trips, and same thing in middle school. And then in high school, there was always a new club or, you know, an interesting class. And I think that HCPSS really does a great job of directing attention and funding to learning beyond the classroom. And that's something that I think is really important for making children learn to love learning. And something that HCPSS could improve on is, I think, encouraging student activism. And that's something that we're really seeing in today's world is becoming really important. You know, teenagers and the youth are leading the charge in a lot of the changes that we're seeing in the socio-political sphere and also in the environmental sphere. And I think that as much as activism has played a role in high schools, it has sometimes been antagonistic.
So we want to see them more engaged with the school affairs, right? And we want to hear their voice, and we want them really get involved with the many decisions which is will shape their future lives.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for sharing that. So do you have some closing remarks?
Yeah, I really appreciate this opportunity to speak with you and by extension to speak with future high schoolers and HCPSS students. I am so thankful for the experience that I've had and this education that I've been given. And I think if there's one thing I can advise you as young students to do is take advantage of all of the opportunities that HCPSS is providing. As I'm starting to get to know some of my future classmates at Columbia, not everyone has these great resources that we have in Howard County. And the more you take initiative and go out to seize the opportunities and seize experiences, the more they'll come back to you. And I'm just so thankful that I've had that ability and had this wonderful learning experience.
Great. I'm really glad to hear that. As a school board member, right, students, their achievement is our one of the metrics to evaluate the school's work, right? If students are doing well, I think we're doing well. Okay. Thank you for sharing that, Lorelei. I really appreciate your time speaking with me. I will continue to interview our high school graduates. I want to hear their story. I want to hear their voice because I feel student voice and experience a valuable story and experience for our school system. And I hope this channel will serve the purpose for our incoming high school students. They will learn the success from our students and learn the failure from our students and then grow and enjoy their high school life. And I really appreciate your time, Lorelei. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For our audience, please subscribe to our channel. We'll continue to have similar interviews for the future. Bye-bye. Mm-hmm.